the dish that I'm going to introduce to you today is a dish that I call Chuncheon Alfredo. Now, you might be wondering what a city in South Korea and an Italian pasta sauce have in common with a name like Chuncheon Alfredo. Well, let me explain myself a little bit. When I lived in Chuncheon, there was a restaurant near the city hall near downtown called Venezia. On the surface, it looked like an old-style, old-world Italian restaurant, and they had a lot of the traditional Italian favorites on the menu. But the first dish that we ordered was a dish called minestrone, and their minestrone was the hottest, the spiciest stuff I'd ever eaten in my life. But it was really good, too, and so every time I'd ever go there, I'd always order the minestrone. And the first few times I would go, I would always wonder why they would serve it so hot, because that's not the traditional minestrone. But, you know, I just kind of came to realize that what they were trying to do is take a traditional Italian favorite like minestrone and adapt it to the Korean sensibilities of the clientele in the area in which they lived. And so in honor of that idea of taking Italian favorites and making them more palatable to Korean tastes, which do tend to lean on the spicy side, I developed this recipe I call Chuncheon Alfredo. 2 tablespoons of dak-kalbi sauce, 3/4 of a cup of milk, 3/4 of a cup of grated or shredded Parmesan cheese, 1/2 a cup of butter, and 8 ounces of cream cheese. To make the Alfredo sauce, pour 3/4 of a cup of milk into a saucepan on medium heat. Don't let the milk come to a rolling boil. A few bubbles on the edges are okay though. When the milk gets warm, start whisking the grated Parmesan cheese into the saucepan just a little bit at a time. Allow the cheese in the pan to melt before whisking more cheese into the sauce. Once the Parmesan cheese is melted, start whisking in the cream cheese. You notice I pre-cut the cream cheese into smaller pieces for easier melting. If you can't find cream cheese in the store where you live, try to find mascarpone instead. It has a similar texture and flavor to cream cheese. Now check your heat periodically. If the sauce looks like it's coming to a complete boil, turn down the heat a little bit. If your cheese or your sauce doesn't seem to be mixing and melting very well, you need to turn up the heat a little bit. Traditionally, one uses heavy whipping cream rather than cream cheese to make an Alfredo sauce. Now, I experimented with this recipe using both kinds of sauces, and I discovered that the version with the cream cheese reheats a lot better and a lot nicer than the version with heavy cream. So that's why I'm showing you the version with cream cheese. Now, this is a good time to get your pasta started. Notice how thick the sauce looks right now? This gives you an idea of how thick the sauce will be once you're done. Now you add the butter, a teaspoon or a tablespoon at a time, and whisk it into the sauce until it is completely melted into the sauce. The last step is to add 2 tablespoons of dak-kalbi sauce. If you like your sauce even spicier, just add another tablespoon of dak-kalbi sauce. Whisk it in quickly and your sauce is complete. Now by now your pasta is probably done, so strain your pasta and put it into a bowl. I've added approximately 2 tablespoons of sesame seeds for a garnish. And I can assure you that if you serve a dish like this, your guests will certainly say to you, "Magnifico, machisayo," because it is really, really good. Thank you for watching.